Things are never quite what they seem. We only see the front, without paying attention to the shadows hiding behind it. All the world is a stage. And all the men and women, merely actors in the tragedy that is life. Recently, mysteries that seem so far away from me are getting closer and are starting to show themselves in the light of truth. My name is Rose Hawkins. I'm an inspector of the Juvenile Division of Massachusetts. For several weeks, I investigated the case of a missing girl named Eden. All of this led me to an old and abandoned asylum in the north of the country. But details are blurring out. My recent memories faded away, as if it was hiding behind a cold and wet fog. When I open my eyes, all I can remember is a man pointing a gun at me and shooting me down. I'm still alive. Is it possible? I'm still bleeding. I need to find something to heal myself. It was more than 10 years ago, and the asylum never opened its doors again.
probably wondering why such a lovely girl like you got into this dark and cold place. Well, my dear, I'm afraid it's your fault. We told you not to trust anyone. Oh, but you probably don't remember anyway. It's one of those side effects caused by the shock that affected your memory. I'm even willing to bet that you don't remember the last few hours. Why did you come to this asylum to investigate? Why did you come alone? What did you find? What happened? And who shot you? So many questions left unanswered.
To get out of this place, I really should find this nurse before she changes her mind.
Thank you.
So I need to find a nurse and free her. What does that mean? I just found my nurse. What happened to her?
To be honest, Doctor, I'm not here to confide my problems to you or some bullshit like that. I don't believe in those stories about working on oneself, subconscious, or neurosis. Just because I'm a nurse doesn't mean I can't see what you're scheming. The reason I came is because I'd like to know what happened to my six patients, Doctor. They didn't magically vanish. What have you done to them? Why were they crying every day after your sessions? Your little experiments on them failed, so you got rid of them? Is that it, Doctor? They were living proofs of your incompetence, and you couldn't stand it? Anyway, you'll understand that I can't close my eyes on such a matter, Doctor. Though money could help me look the other way.
An old surface elevator. I should check if it's still working. Thank you. kind of experiment they conducted here. Seems I'm not alone here. Thank you. This place is creepy. Hiding, Dr. Walton. Girl? What's a girl doing here? Hey, sweetie. Are you okay? What are you doing here? My name is Rose. What's your name? She's ignoring me. I need to find a way to open this gate. Don't worry. I'm going to get you out of here. Stay there, okay? Crap. Where did she go? Sweetie? Where are you? Don't be scared. I'm not going to hurt you. Let me get you out of here.
Most people disregard the shadow inside them. We can perceive it in somatic sleep, in obsessions, or in some delirious fantasies. It represents the stupidity and the cruelty one would regret admitting. It lays at the root of jealousy and disgust.
There was a little girl there. Am I going insane?
Thank you.
a shotgun?
Hello, Noah.
Hi, Dorothy.
How are you feeling this morning? Your sisters look quite nervous.
We're nervous because of tomorrow's appointment with Walton. Oh, and Dorothy, they're not my sisters. It's just a stupid nickname someone gave us.
I know. I'm sorry. Anyway, I thought about the offer you made the other day. Your freedom for Walton's reputation.
So what about it?
Well, I have a little something for you. Here, take it. Use this before taking your shower tonight.
Is this a hair dye?
Hope you don't mind redheads.
But what's it for? I don't get it.
I can't get you out of here right now, but at least I can hide you. We're always looking for new staff here, and I heard they're trying to find nurses for the men's building.
You want me to hide as a nurse? Is this a joke?
Just for a few days. It'll only be temporary. No one will recognize you there. They've never seen you before. You just need to keep a low profile. Think you can do it?
Noah? Is that the same Noah I met earlier?
Building that's under renovation. Hey, yeah, it was really weird. and spent a lot of time to design it.
And Miss Millers, where was she?
She was just sitting there in front of her work, crying. I tried to explain to her that they had all died a long time ago, but she didn't want to listen to me.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson. Do you have anything else to say?
Well, may I say that as the new head of security, I promise you I'm going to improve things around here during the night, and especially for any difficult cases like Miss Miller's.
Nathan Barnes speaking. Oh, Rose, it's you. Listen, forget what happened earlier. I didn't mean that. I'm sorry. What? How? Damn, Rose, don't tell me you went there alone. No, please, don't tell me you're sorry. You know you don't. Every time it's the same story. You never listen to me. Because I'm your partner. That means we've worked together. Oh, please. You know you're not gonna find anything there. The girl disappeared from a Boston orphanage, not some old place at the other end of the state. You see, that's your problem. It's always complicated with you, Rose. Damn! Listen, no. Listen, Rose. I'm coming up. Wait for me to get there and we'll search the asylum together. And don't do anything stupid before I get there, all right?
What does that mean?